Let us discuss about vector representation of gravitational force. A little idea about vector representation we have just taken in the previous section when we were applying Newton's law of gravitation on extended bodies. Say we are given with two masses m1 and m2 and we are given that the position vector of m2 with respect to m1 is r vector. We know well that gravitational force will be attractive and the two masses will experience the force F and F dash vectors towards each other. And obviously in magnitude the two forces must be equal as these are action reactions. So we can write F vector is negative of F dash vector. In this situation if we wish to find out the magnitude of these forces, the force which is acting on M2 applied by M1, this can be given as the magnitude F, if we consider the magnitude of F vector, this equals to magnitude of F dash vector and say this equals to F, then the magnitude can be written as simply gm1 m2 by r square. According to Newton's law of gravitation, if we wish to write down the vector form of these forces, we can write here in the situation F dash vector, which is the force acting on M2. It is opposite to R vector, so it can be given as a negative of gm1 m2 by R square, R cap, that is the direction vector along R vector. And the direction vector or unit vector along R vector can be written as R vector by its modulus. So when we substitute here, this F dash vector can be written as minus gm1 m2 by r cube multiplied by r vector. This is the way how the vector form is written. And if we wish to write down the force acting on m1, it is written as negative of f dash. So f vector which is applied by m2 on m1 can be written as gm1 m2 by r cube r vector. This is the way how we write. So be careful about this vector representation. Several times it can be used whenever position vector of masses are given in a coordinate system.